Now, I have been using these billhooks for a while. Nice performance in a lot of areas. Been doing some relatively heavy work with them. Weeding, that kind of stuff. One of the main issues that came up relatively fast and relatively obvious is this bevel that they have, this just single bevel, is relatively heavy in profile when you consider it's the only bevel that's on the knife. It's about 12 degrees, varies a bit. I've got four of these, they all bounce around about a little. But it's about 12 degrees per side. But again, it's the only bevel that's on the knife. So when you're doing heavier cutting, especially chopping, all of the force gets basically absorbed, to say, by this very narrow bevel. As compared to a knife like this, which has a much higher bevel, it's essentially the full width of the knife, and then a small secondary edge. So when you're chopping, you get a much more smooth transfer over the entire bevel. So what I did was I took one of the billhooks and I put a much higher bevel on it. Now the actual very edge still has the original angle around 12 degrees per side. Again, changes from, I got about four of these, but it has a much higher relief grind. I'll put the full details of that in the description. But this gives it a much more smooth cut when you're going into materials, because again, you don't have this very abrupt transition where you have this very narrow edge and then flat stop. You have your little secondary edge bevel, then a smooth, very high transition, and then into the flat stock. Now, regrinding this was a bit of a chore, mainly because this was obviously forged, and parts of the blade were a bit thicker than others. So, for example, there was a large hump right here on this side, and a large hump right here on this side. Again, obviously forged, bit of differences. So, when I was grinding this out, I had to remove a lot of material around here, and a lot of material up here. And I think that inconsistency, where parts of the edge were thicker and thinner than others, may have made it a bit more uncomfortable and a bit more feedback when I was cutting. So I'm going to look forward to trying this one out now and comparing it to this one, which still has the original grind, and doing some work with it. It should be kind of interesting. One of the things I'm going to do now is to use this for a pretty unconventional task, which may even seem to be a bit ridiculous. But you have to understand, in a lot of different parts of the world, it's not like they have a huge, ginormous amount of knives which they optimize for each individual task. Sometimes you can often see, especially in villages and places like that, they have one knife, and that one knife gets used for pretty much anything. Gardening, wood cutting, food preparation, that kind of deal. So I'm going to see how this fares. Now, so, this is not a terribly complicated task, but it's going to be made a little non-trivial due to the knife not being exactly optimal. It's also not fully thawed out, which doesn't make the job that much easier. So now it's mostly broken up pieces. Now I'll just trim off the skin because I can render this down. Now, here's the tricky bit. Now, so as expected, removing the tenders and isolating the very fine bits of meat are not nearly as easy to do with a knife like this, but it's not what I would call overly difficult. And if I had to look at how difficult it is to break down a chicken with this compared to how difficult it would be to build a small shelter with this, there's no comparison. So when you're looking at choices made where people have to use one knife for an awful lot of uses, it's not surprising that you end up with knives like this. The only major change that I think I'd make to this immediately is you saw how often I was trying to use the tip for precision work. If I was using this sort of as my one knife for a lot of work, I'd really thin this out. The only downside to that though is that this is the same area that gets used very heavily when you're weeding, when you're doing any kind of low brush cutting, when you're digging in the ground. This gets really beat up. So you're going to have to make some kind of judgment call there. Do you leave this nice and really fine to help you when you're doing this work, so when you're trying to pick out the smaller parts of the meat, it goes through it nice and evenly? Or do you leave it nice and durable so that you can use it for all that digging work without it being too heavily damaged? So, I mean, if it was me, all I'd do is I'd sharpen it really, really fine. I'd bring this bevel right up, make it nice and acute, and then just put a relatively shallow micro bevel on it. And then as it got beat up, just maintain it. So, that's that. Now, we got our breasts. They're nice and cleaned up. They can go exactly as they are. Our tenders, which were abrupt lies, but such is life. It's gonna all go in the stock pot. Now, see again, this is kind of difficult to do. And a lot of the times that I saw people actually working with these larger knives, they weren't working with them on flat boards like this. They were often working with them on elevated boards, almost like chopping blocks. So they could work with this section and the pieces would actually be over the top of it. Again, let's just take the skin off of this so I can render this down. That was actually the whole upper part of the carcass that came off. Last of the stock. So I mean, would I jump at this to clean up a chicken or a turkey with it? Obviously not. If I was going to do it, what I would want is not a flat chopping block like this, or I'd want one of these, but on the side, I'd want like say an 8-inch block, which when I had to chop through the bones or that kind of stuff, I could just shift them right up and easily chop through them. Like for example, right now I want to separate out the leg and the thigh. Now there's a line that runs up between the two of these, which is right over where the joint is. However, I can't actually cut that flat to the cutting board with this knife, but if this was on a block, I easily could. Now you just saw with this knife, I had to stop and cut around the joints rather than try to press through. The problem is this knife is so thin, it's only a 32nd of an inch thick, that it flexes immediately as soon as you try to do heavier cutting with it. It's wonderful for smaller tasks in the kitchen, but if you don't have it exactly where it needs to be, it'll just bend around the joints rather than try to cut through them. So I've got to be really precise and open this up. Just right there. So with a heavier knife, be no problem. Just rock through that. But with this one, I had to actually go right around because I couldn't even cut through the outer edges of those. I want to see maybe I can get through the wingtips. See if it can handle that. It's right there. Yep. So, smaller bones like that, no problem. But again, on the heavier ones, the knife actually just starts to flex, and I can feel the whole knife bending back and forth, and it's not a good idea to keep cutting in that situation because your edge is bending around like crazy. But on the smaller ones, no problem. Go straight through the joints if you need to. So, that's our chicken cut up. I'd call that relatively brutalized if I had to put a name to it, but it just shows that you can do it. It's not easy, it's not optimal, not even what I'd call comfortable or efficient, but again, it's much easier to do a light job with a knife like this than a heavy job with a knife like this. So, when they were looking at, and often you'll see, like I said, especially in villages and a lot of rural areas where they're using just one knife for a large variety of tasks, they always end up using a great big heavy knife, because it'll handle the harder work relatively easy, and it's just a bit awkward on the lighter work.